I don't know if you can hear it. Hello, everybody. Sonny, the Songfather Grosso here for podcast number, I don't know. But there are, in a six-block radius, seven or eight different tree companies taking trees down all around here in beautiful downtown Merrick on the island of Long. So I hope it's not interfering with the microphone. But, my God, I don't know why all of a sudden they're cutting trees down. They're trimming the trees, taking them down, branches and... But anyway, so let's get on with it. Tuesday, November 10th, my BriBri's birthday. Happy birthday, BriBri. 21 years old. She is now completely legal. That's not a good thing. But anyway, so what song I'm thinking all last night could I start this day off with? Because the rumblings have started. The investigations have started. Witnesses are being gathered. Whistleblowers are jumping out of the woodwork. There's only one song you can play for Mr. Donald Trump right now, the President of the United States, at least for another 6 to 8 weeks, and that is the Bee Gees. Woo! Daddy-o! Because he's staying alive. Just We'll see. Yeah. Yeah, here we go. The uprising is beginning across the country. Trucks. I forget where it was. Silly of me. But I saw a picture, a video on, I forget what it was. Maybe it was Instagram or Facebook or whatever. But of trucks, hundreds of them going down the road in a convoy. I haven't seen a convoy in a long time. And it was miles long, and with the lights and beeping the horns and flags, Trump train and all. Whatever happens, it's going to be exciting over the next couple of weeks. Everybody keeps bringing up when Al Gore was doing what Joe Biden's doing right now, and getting his cabinet together. And I mean, Biden's already asking for money so we can set his team up and set his transition team and this team, and so we can start paying him a salary. And you haven't been elected yet. Take it easy. But Al Gore, I think, was celebrating his victory for 30-something days before he uncelebrated it. So whatever the turnout's going to be, it is going to be one hell of a show to watch. Let me tell you, it's going to be amazing. And Trump has got his bazooka all loaded up and ready to start firing. As far as the voting, and especially in anywhere from 5 to 10 states, and at the very least, you know, it's at the Supreme Court, and it's in a bunch of other courts, and at the very least, if he gets anything he wants, they'll recount those states. Two of them, I think, are already doing it. I think Georgia is definitely one of them doing a recount, but they might have to do the whole election over again. And it's like I said yesterday, you know, even the powers to be on the Democratic side, from Biden all the way down, maybe they didn't know. And it's probably a strong possibility that they didn't know. But it doesn't matter. If it's proven that it did happen, and as all these whistleblowers are coming out now, then it doesn't matter whether you knew or you didn't do. You condoned it, you didn't condone it. It doesn't matter. What matters is that there was fraud at whatever level it was, and they need to be recounted, and it has to be in person. That's it. No more of this write-in bullshit. I mean, that is, it is just ridiculous. And I remember screaming, I'm not the only one, but screaming at the top of my lungs, and not for any side, just screaming for the process, saying, wait a minute, you're blaming COVID for the need to have people stay home and not spread the disease around, or God forbid catch the disease. Okay, I kind of understand that, but there's other ways to do it. But to push the way they pushed and pushed for this write-in stuff, and I kept screaming at the top of my lungs saying it's so open to fraud that way, there's no check and balance on it. And I told you about my friend's father who stood in line for almost 2 hours, him and his wife. And when they finally got in, they go up and boom, boom. Oh, you voted already, sir. I did not vote already. I've been standing outside for 2 hours. Well, it says here that you voted already. And they didn't let him vote. And he's a registered Republican. I don't know what that means. I don't know if they did it on purpose. I don't know if it was flat-out collusion. I have no idea. All I know is there's two votes, because the same thing happened with the mother. So there's two votes, Republican votes, that they didn't get in. Oh, what's two votes going to make? Who knows how many times it was done? And then I was had a cup of coffee this morning with my friend Ray, retired NYPD lieutenant, good guy, good friend. We worked together at that hospital. And a friend of his parents were down for voting. And they too were registered, they were registered Democrats, not Republican. And so there's a list that you can go to. I don't know, whatever. But his parents were on the list as voting for Joe Biden. And, so his parents have been dead. His father died 11 years ago. His mother died 4 years ago. What? So he, made a big complaint and wrote letters and whatever he did. I don't know. And, so there you go. Oh, okay, so they balance each other out. No, they don't balance each other out. If there's outright fraud going on there, people need to get locked up. I don't care what level they're at. I don't care where it ends up. I don't care if you go up the trail and it takes you all the way into Joe Biden's campaign headquarters. Whatever it is, people got to get locked up for it. That is a complete disgrace and disrespect to the whole system of voting. You know? Really makes you shake your head. Hey, boy. So, it'll be fun anyway. So, just make sure you watch out for flying bazooka bombs and stuff. So, and, the Prez is, business as usual and doing his thing. You know, signing this, signing that. Fired his guy, hired his guy, whatever. You know, made a nice big announcement about the Pfizer vaccine. Did not pat himself on the back. Did not try to, say anything derogatory about anybody about it. Just made the announcement and what great news it is for America, and fine. Meanwhile, on the other side of the coin, the transition team, Biden's team, is little by little trying to grab the glory and grab all, the support and the wave of enthusiasm that this thing is almost done, as if he had anything to do with it. Really a bizarre thing, like I said. He ripped the Band-Aids off the scars across this country. He ripped off the masks and showed everybody for what they really are, and especially the Democratic Party. And you look across this country, and nobody, I haven't heard of one riot, one window being broken, nothing. You know, a couple of things here and there between Antifa and BLM and Trump supporters or whatever, but, isolated fist fights and everything, but not out and out destruction of police departments and cars and buildings and windows and businesses and fires and not one across the country. Are Republicans upset? Were they upset with the numbers? Were they upset with going to sleep with 5 to 15 states Trump ahead? And then waking up and seeing Trump behind while they were asleep and finding out who stopped counting and it's just a complete, as they say in the military, clusterfuck. And now, everybody's up in arms. What do we do? What do we do? Keep denying it? What do we do to try to make it right? Or what do we got to do? Do it over? We got to count this state, this precinct over, this city over? We don't have to count all of Pennsylvania over, but maybe we got to do Philly. No, it's got to be all done over. And if I had any kind of say, me personally, I'm sure there's a lot of people that agree, and of course a lot that won't. Do the whole election over 6 months from now, 3 months from now, a year from now, do it next November, whatever it is, and make sure it's done 100% right. Take everything off, and all the efforts go now to this vaccine, and not just here in the country, but worldwide. But, all the testing has been done outside of this country. All right. Okay, I'll go for that. Go ahead. Test everybody. And with over 90% success rate, that's good news. That's something good to look forward to. But when is it going to come here? So way back when Trump said, we should have that vaccine somewhere around Thanksgiving, being close to finalized and hopefully ready to distribute before the end of the year. Everybody jumped on him, everybody, every Democrat. Dr. Fauci, it was unbelievable what they did to this man, calling him irresponsible and unprofessional. And when it looks like all is said and done and he's out, all of a sudden, Pfizer has an announcement to make. Now, we have a success rate of over 90%, and the vaccine will be out and available for distribution before the year is up. Not one bee. All you heard was crickets. Quick, 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 quick. That's it. Nobody screamed. Nobody. Scary. Scary place to live right now. Scary place. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. But as of right now, the Bee Gees are singing the song, Still Alive, Still Alive, beep, beep, beep. So tomorrow, I mean today, the 10th of November, like I said, Sabrina, BriBri's birthday, and was my grandpop's birthday. It's gone a long time, but, it, you know, it's just, you know, some dates and some people stay in your mind forever. And, you know, the 10th of November will always be Gramps' birthday, too, and, of course, BriBri's. You know, but it's also happy birthday to the United States Marine Corps. Golly Shazam, Sergeant Carter. So, yeah, happy birthday to the Marine Corps. Let's listen to a little patriotic Bamba da Bingo. Yeah! Pile! Drop and give me 25. Golly! Gives you goosebumps. That's a duck, you asshole. Oh, sorry. John Philip Sousa. Ah. Here we go. Let's hear it. Hey! Bam 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 bam. Happy birthday, the United States Marine Corps. The few, the proud, the Marines. Semper Fi, everybody. So, yeah, there you go. Very exciting. And tomorrow, 11-11, I call Angel Day. I think we're celebrating Veterans Day tomorrow. Why it wasn't a three-day weekend, I'm not quite sure, but... But 11-11, if you're not familiar with that, is the international symbol for angels. It's it represents the gates of heaven and the angels there. And so many people across this world whenever it's 11:11 on a clock, they will put that on their social media. We'll send it through a text to their loved ones and their family and everything. And so 11:11 will always be Angel Day as far as I'm concerned. We got a lot of angels up there in heaven. And I was telling my sister Donna this morning before I was going to meet Ray for a cup of coffee. I was in the bathroom getting ready, you know. It doesn't take that much because I am pretty damn good looking. But out of nowhere, I heard, that was Daddy-O's whistle, you know. And then, you know, oftentimes when you didn't answer right away, then it became louder and a little slower, you know. But as I look around like, what the heck? You know, I continue doing what I'm doing, and then I hear it again. What the fuck? I even get into the table, look out the window, into the tub, and look out the window. I love being in a shower where there's a window. You could just, you know, look out and relax. And I looked to see if anybody was in the backyard or if it was a friend out in the street. And I went on the Ring camera and looked to see if somebody was out whistling for me. No. I said, all right. Hi, Daddy-O. What are you doing here? Good to see you. Hey, blah, blah, blah. I know, and I believe in that. Like the song I wrote, Heaven's Phone. It's about, you know, you can use Heaven's Phone and call Heaven anytime you want, but you got to believe. You got to believe that they'll hear you, and you got to, you know, free your mind, and you can hear them talking back to you. And I heard Daddy-O say, listen, don't worry, I won't say the person's name, but let's just say it's Karen. Don't worry about Karen, everything's going to be okay. Now, I've been having problems with this Karen. This whole family's been having problems with this quote-unquote Karen. But he said, don't worry about it, okay? Just relax. It's all taken care of. All right, Dad, whatever you say. So I go on to do what I got to do. Boom, get in the car. I go meet Ray. We have some coffee. We discuss all the problems of the world and solve them in a little over an hour, which is what we do every time we meet for coffee. Then on the way home, I had to stop and get some bird food for Tino the Wonder Bird. I couldn't believe I ran out. I felt so bad. He was mad at me, too. He gave me the finger. No, he gave me the feather. Excuse me. And I get a text from a friend, a lawyer friend, that's handling some things for us. And Daddy-O was right. No more problems with Karen. It's all been taken care of. You know, no. She's alive. But it was like, holy shit. You got to be kidding me. You know, I haven't heard that whistle, and I've been, you know, missing him a lot. I mean, a lot. And to hear those two whistles, and then to hear him saying, hey, relax, you know. Everything's okay. It's going to be okay. Don't worry about, quote-unquote, Karen. And then, I don't know, 2 hours later, to get that text saying it's all done. Oh, my goodness. That's amazing. It's an amazing bunch of news, let me tell you that. And here on the island of Long, I believe that we are, almost into the middle of November, and 3 days in a row of 60, 70 degrees, not a cloud in the sky. I mean, wow. You know, walking around and, nice little breeze, no humidity. What? And sure enough, it's all going to end. It's all going to end in the next day or so. But it was a nice gift from God, sending it down, and unfortunately down south, which I didn't. I knew that this hurricane, whatever it's called, Etta, I think, or I don't know, but it was coming in, and it was going to hit, you know, into the Gulf and kind of hit and bounce off the west coast of Florida. All right. Got a lot of friends down there, too, you know, in Naples and Fort Myers and stuff like that. And I'd say prayers. And if it does hug the coast, then, you know, I got friends in Tampa. And so it is, you know, it kept going back and forth. It was a hurricane, tropical storm. Okay. And usually with a storm like that, either it totally fizzles out or it becomes like a monster. And then I hear that it crossed over Florida, kind of split a little bit, went on both sides or whatever. And Fort Lauderdale got like 14 inches of rain, and they had helicopter shots of the ocean coming in. It was like a tsunami, and just completely, you couldn't even see the roads. You couldn't see people's backyards. The ocean was like, you know, a mile or two already, up the coast. And like, holy Christ, you got to be kidding me. And now here on the Island of Long in the New York viewing area, starting tomorrow through tonight and into Thursday, we could get possibly, which is a lot for here, 2 to 3 inches of rain, you know, and heavy winds and everything, like, and still from the same storm. So this storm that was supposed to, it's not no weather people's fault, no computer's fault, that you can't help anything with, right? And they said that, so you can't get mad at them. They didn't say it's definitely this, and then they were wrong. That you know, it looked like, or it certainly had the tracking to peter out because it had been downgraded to a tropical storm, and they were talking about if it stays this way pretty soon. This was yesterday, late yesterday. It'll be downgraded to a tropical depression. Okay, good. I guess it went the other way and everything, but to go across the state and dump 14 inches of rain on Fort Lauderdale, Miami was underwater too, and wow. So, you know, people still aren't happy up there. Mother Nature, she's not very happy. It's not nice to fool with Mother Nature. Don't do it. And what else here? I'm watching the news, which I try not to do. And they had the sports guy come on. And he says the Giants are tied for first place, or they will be tied, or they could, whatever. And they have a very good chance, based on the rest of the schedule. I think they're 2-8 now. On the rest of the schedule, they have a very good chance to win the division. I was like, what? Even though they only won their second game over the weekend. What? Is that what sports has come to? Especially the NFL. And because of everything they did, and because of a lot of things that they said, you know, very disrespectful to the United States in general, very disrespectful to our troops and our president, and very disrespectful to the people that are paying them, and I mean, you know, and against police officers, I mean, all over. When your main job is to go out there and keep your mouth shut, play the game that you're getting paid so ridiculously for, you know, so I couldn't bring myself to watch any NFL this year. And not that I watch a lot of games. It's usually just the Giants and maybe once in a while the Jets and Miami. I always like the Dolphins, even though nothing's the same. Nobody's the same. And, of course, OBJ, who's still, you know, a complete friggin' maniac, but I love him. But I haven't watched anything. And I'm like, wow, could you imagine? You're 2-9 or 2-10 right now. And, 2-8. Right? Yeah, they're 2-8. So you have the chance to win your division with only, maybe 6 games left to go, right? And you have a chance to win your division with only 2 wins? What the hell? What are these people doing out there? Unbelievable. But, hey, what are you going to do? I might have to come out of my boycott if they do that. Could you imagine? Imagine if they ended up winning the whole thing. Hoo! It's been a long time. And, you know, especially today on Gramps' birthday. And that's what we called him, Gramps. And he was, like me and my father, like Daddy-O, diehard, want to put a gun to my head, Giant fan. Especially all the way back to the Allie Sherman days and everything else. And, you know, like, oh God. I remember he unfortunately got hit by a car. And he was in a coma for a while. And I mean a while. He fought like hell, you know. And so Sonny, who was at the time maybe 2-3 years old, we go up and see him good 3-4 times a week and go spend some time with him. And just, you know, I'd read the paper to him and, you know, tell him how the Giants were doing. And I swear to God, you'd see the machines beep a little bit, you know. Like I believe that when you're in a coma, you could still hear. That's my belief, and I'm sticking with it. But I would notice that, you know, it was almost like his eyes and his hands would start trembling, like, don't mention the Giants, you son of a... And so I'm sure he's looking down from up there when they won a couple there, and he's like, all right, what's going on now? It's back to the same old shit. That's what he used to say. Did you watch the Giant game today, Sal? Yeah, I did. Yeah, same old shit, right? Anyway. So, happy birthday, Gramps. We miss you. And what do we got? Yeah, that's right. Oh, my God. There's only about a month left to the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Best of Long Island contest they have every year. It's like their 11th or 12th year doing this now. And there's a hell of a lot of categories involved in it. You know, from businesses and services and performers and singers and writers and poets. And I mean, it's just, it's a great thing. And everybody gets to vote. You get 2 months of solid seven days a week voting. Only one vote a day is allowed to stop, you know, people from cheating and, you know, putting bots on and you know, tabulating the votes like they do in some states here in this country. But so, yeah, please, if you've been voting and kind of tailed off, you forget, you know, life does that to us. Get back on track if you can for the last month and share it and tell everybody you know. Just go to the Bethpage Federal Credit Union, and or you could just type in BOLI, because they're called the Boley Awards for the Best of Long Island. You know, or just type in Best of Long Island. It'll take you to the site. Under Arts and Entertainment, go to Singer from Long Island. Look for Sonny Grosso and vote for me every day. Get everybody doing it. I want to win this goddamn thing. You know, just my second year in a row of being nominated. And I still have no idea who nominated me, but I liked it. Thank you very much for doing that. So, yeah, just about a month left. Let me win this one. Let me win it. I don't know how much time I got left now. Come on. So anyway, there you go. It's nice and quiet now. I don't know if you can hear it. I guess it must be quitting time for the tree people. 3:30, yeah, that's about right. But unfortunately, while I'm sitting here on the island of Long in the penthouse suite, no birds here in the trees. I'm not seeing any blue jays or cardinals or anything because of all the friggin' noise. And, you know, so now that it's quiet, maybe they'll come back. And as the leaves blow past my window pane. Excuse me. As the leaves disappear, so do the birds, because they got no camouflage to hide behind. And, you know, I don't know why or how that was inbred in them that if they're not being able to hide, they're open targets for what? You know, there's a lot of crazy cats out there, but none of them are carrying guns or anything, so I don't know. But so I hope I get to see them a little bit more before they take off and wherever they go into their hiding, you know, into their condos, or they go down south. If they go down south now, they're going to be like, what the hell is going on with this earth? There's no leaves up north, and there's no land down south. There's a lot of water to poop on, though, you know? So, anyway, nice and quiet. I love it. So, let's see now. Where are we? Oh, nice. Okay. So, we have to decide what's going to happen as things go on. You know, are we going to be what the Beatles say? Is this what the powers to be, or the new powers to be, and some of the old powers to be, is this where they're going to be heading? I don't know. Maybe you know. You got to listen for the train, the plane. You never know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was filled with votes.
Come back in the USSR. You don't know how lucky you are, boy. Come back in the USSR. Been away so long, I hardly knew the place. Gee, it's good to be back home. Leave it to tomorrow to unpack my case. Honey, disconnect the phone. I'm back in the USSR. You know how lucky you are, boy. Back in the U.S., back in the U.S., back in the USSR.
Listen closely. Will the Ukraine girls really knock me out? Boom, 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 boom.
Make me sing and shout. The JoJo's always on my. Whoa!
Come on, guys and girls, you gotta have fun.
Yeah, we're back in the USSR. You know how lucky you are, boy. Back in the USA.
Here we go.
Well, the Ukraine girls really knock me out to leave the rest behind. And Moscow girls make me sing and shout. And Georgia's always on my mind. Whoa! Travel me around, there's no big mountains way down south. Take me to your daddy's farm. Let me hear your mala like it's ringing out. Come and keep your comrades warm. I'm back in the USA song. Hey! You know how lucky you are, boy. Back in the USA song.
Yeah, pass those votes over here. I got to bring a million votes to Putin. I crack myself up. Yes, I do. I got to be honest. So, flicking the channels a little earlier before I came on here to do the podcast. And on one channel, it was a blip of Joe Biden talking about cracking down across this country, mandatory wearing of masks 24 hours a day until we can get this thing, you know, under control. And then you flick the switch and the very next channel, I'm not giving them any credit what the news channels were, but, you know, at least here in New York, on cable vision or Optimum, whatever you want to call it, the three or four maniacal news stations are one right after the other. So one is Biden talking about mandatory across the country wearing masks 24 hours a day until we can understand and get some kind of a hold on this virus. And then the very next thing is everybody jubilating, enjoying, and celebrating about the announcement out of Pfizer. It's like nobody knows what the hell is happening. Nobody knows what's important. Let me take that back. They know what's important, both sides of the coin. They all know what's important. But they don't deal with what's important. They deal with what's going to shock you the most. They deal with what's going to get more people to start listening to you. You know, so if Biden cannot come out and say, or his people cannot come out and say what a great job they've done, and it's due to the pressure that they put on and everything else to get this thing done as quick as we can, because he's not involved in it. So we can't talk about that. So what he will do is, and it's the spinning, they call that. You don't put a spin on it. Make everybody get pissed off and say, oh, you got to be kidding me. He's going to make us wear a mask 24 hours a day. And then as the other story develops, and as he slides into the presidency and Trump is slides out, then he'll wait like a month or so, whatever, and say, I'm removing the ban. We have pushed as quick and as hard and as safely as we can. The vaccine is now ready, and we're going to start distributing it throughout this country. And little by little, that ban is coming off. I say the mask ban will be will be taken off within the next at the most a month, and everybody will rejoice and say thank you, President Biden, for doing that for us. I don't want to wear a mask anymore. Okay, whatever. And if it was the other way around, it would be the same thing. So don't get me wrong. Don't get me crazy. But yeah, one channel and then right to the next channel. Fake news or made up news or unimportant news. And Lucky Boy, my sister Donna and John, her son John, their husky that lives downstairs and up here with Uncle Sonny. Had been sick for, I don't know, a couple of weeks now. He just wasn't himself. And then all of a sudden he was violently throwing up and then buying diarrhea and whatever. It turns out he's got to be gluten-free, which is a common thing, I guess, in huskies. But he's been very picky since we rescued him as a family. And he's been very picky about eating anyway, and as most huskies are. But when a husky's hungry, they'll eat anything. They'll eat the couch. They'll eat the birds. They don't care. And so it was very hard to bear. He will not eat any dry food. He will not eat, and she doesn't want to buy any of the wet food because it's really not good for dogs in general, but for huskies especially. And So they ran some tests, to make a long story short. Boom. Second day of giving him B12 shots, and he was hanging out, and we were wrestling in the backyard. He was running all over the place, and he ate like he was going to the electric chair last night. So good news for Lucky. He's getting back to being abnormal, which we like. Because it was, you know, it's like a kid. You know, anybody that has any kind of pets, they become part of the family. And, you know, when somebody in your family is not feeling well and all, you know, they have no energy, and you know, you lost like 6 pounds in a week and a half, and you start to get scared, and they become, you know, very lethargic, and all they want to do is lay around. When you're not used to seeing that, it's very, very depressing, and anxiety, you know, starts to build in, like, oh, my God, is he going to pass away, and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, even though there's so many companies out there now that say, you know, they have health coverage for pets. And you think, wow, this is unbelievable. This is great. It's about time they finally did that. You know, when are they going to get around to doing something about these dentists out there? Don't even get me started on that. I'll save that for another show. But they only cover medicine. They don't cover x-rays. They don't cover any procedures. They don't cover any surgeries. They don't, all that's got to come out of pocket. They will cover an office visit, and they'll cover you know, a certain percentage of any medicine or pills or whatever it is that you got to give them. But and they'll ask for $100 a month or whatever it might be, or $50 a month. You know, let's get a task force and get those scammers down, and, you know, make them stop paying it back, because that is unacceptable, ladies and gentlemen. But look what they did. They did a great job. So, you know, whatever the cost might be, it might be a pain in the ass. But whoever gets that. What's wrong with the dog? And he does, yeah, it's probably gluten-free. What? Nobody would ever say that. And that's what it was. He's got to be gluten-free. And let's get him up a little bit. He's a little low. Let's get him a couple. And, you know, and she's giving him the shots right here at home. Don't hear a squeak out of him. He doesn't run away. He doesn't cry. He doesn't nip. Yeah, give me the shot. All right, thanks. So, good news on all fronts. Tino the Wonder Bird is happy. He got his food back. And Lucky the Wonder Dog is well on his way to going back to being normal, enjoying life. Because he's a fun-loving guy. Huskies are the best. They are just the most fun, crazy, mixed-up, maniacal dogs you ever want to meet in your life. They are the canine equivalent of me. So, think about that. Let that sink into your head if you must. But let's not hope. Let's hope that we don't have to start singing this song. Then we get ready to wrap it up. Eric Burden and the Animals. They got a theme song for us too right now. If there was a place to go, I think we'd all be going anyway.
This dirty old part of the city.
Yeah.
Where the sun refused to shine. People tell me there ain't no use in crying.
My love, you're so young and pretty.
And one thing I know is true.
You'll be dead before your time is through. I know it. In bed and crying.
Watch his hand to me,
Gray.
He's been working and slaving his life
away.
Oh, yeah. He's been working so hard.
Whoa. Gotta get out of this bed. The last thing we ever do. We gotta get out of this bed. Girl, there's a better life for me and you. Oh, yeah.
Now, my girl,
you're so young and pretty.
And one thing I know is
true. You'll be dead before your time is through. Yes, you will.
Watch my daddy in bed and time. Watch his hand been a turning gray. He's been
working, working.
Bum, 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 bum.
We gotta get out of this place. If it's the last thing we ever do,
we gotta get out of this place. Girl, there's a better life for me and you. Oh, you know it is. If it's the last thing we ever do, we gotta get out of this place. Girl, there's a better life for me and you.
Yeah.
Believe me, baby.
I believe you.
I know it, baby. You know it, too.
It is true.
America, your children have an amazing superpower. They can help save lives by not having playdates. That's right. By replacing get-togethers with virtual playdates and video chats, they can help slow the evil spread of germs. And if your superheroes do go outside, make sure they continue their superhero wing by staying 6 feet away from others to protect everyone in America land. Find out more at coronavirus.gov. A message from the CDC and the Ad Council.
Correct. Always got to put that in there when I remember. There's a whole bunch of other ones, too. But, you know, for right now, especially if we are that close to that vaccine, let's not get stupid now and start taking masks off and taking chances and everything else and jeopardizing ourselves and our loved ones and friends and family and strangers and everybody else. We are all related across this country when it comes to the COVID. So let's do the right thing. Do the right thing. Let me go over my notes, make sure. I think I got everything. I think I covered everything I could cover. Well, not that I could cover, but that I wanted to cover today. And yes, of course. Okay. Yes. So, all right. So, you know, keep those cards and letters coming in. Be nice to everybody that you meet. Do things for the people that are less fortunate, like the homeless and the shut-ins and the elderly and the disabled. And, you know, just be there for each other because we are all we got no matter what happens. It's, you know, it's life. What can you say? Sometimes you're riding high in April and sometimes you're shot down in May. So I'm going to sing that out. Everybody have a good rest of the day. And tomorrow, happy Angel Day on 11/11. Ciao. Let's go with the music here, huh? Come on, these people got things to do. Thank you. Ah, it's unbelievable sometimes. That's life. That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune when I'm back on top in June. I said that's life, and as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on your dream. But I don't let it get me down, 'cause this final world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. That's life. And I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. I thought it was worth one single try.
I'd jump right on a big bird, then I'd fly. Well, I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I learned one thing. Each time I find myself laying flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. That's life. And I can't deny it. Many times I thought of cutting out, my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and you never get out of it alive. Have a good day, everybody.